But it wasn't just mistranslations, ladies and gentlemen. It was factual errors that bothered me. Now, I don't have lists to go through all of them. I have this much notes with me at home. And of course, in the interest of time, I did not bring all of them here. But let me share some of the factual errors that this man made in his book. For example, Surah Al-Ma'idah, Surah Al-Nisa, chapter 5, verse 3, he says, "And before the Prophet died, he shared with the Muslims the last revelation he received from God. Today I've completed your faith for you." Now Mr. Fateh is so confident that this is the last verse of the Quran, of the Quranic revelation, that he doesn't mention it once. He mentions it in page 20, in page 93, in page 110, in page 114, in page 264. The only problem, Mr. Fateh, is this is not the last verse. This was revealed 81 days before Prophet ﷺ died. The last verse is 2281. That was revealed 9 days before the Prophet died. Now this is uncontested among scholars. Surah An-Nisa, chapter 5, verse 3, he says, "And before the Prophet died, he shared with the Muslims the last revelation he received from God. Today I've completed your faith for you." Now Mr. Fateh is so confident that this is the last verse of the Quran, of the Quranic revelation, that he doesn't mention it once. He mentions it in page 20, in page 93, in page 110, in page 114, in page 264. The only problem, Mr. Fateh, is this is not the last verse. This was revealed 81 days before Prophet ﷺ died. The last verse is 2281. That was revealed 9 days before the Prophet died. Now this is uncontested among scholars.